So these are the list of President George Weah major achievement in 6 years period. I'm giving the list from a completely neutral perspective. That is why I carefully research this information from reliable sources like World Health Organization, Johns Hopkins University of Medicine, allafrica.com. I did not use any Liberian website. I also have to make it clear, I was not paid by the Liberian government to make this video. I'm simply a content creator who feel like I should keep you informed about Liberia. It's that simple. So, with that being said, I will give you the George Weah administration achievement sector by sector. For example, what are achievements done in the infrastructure sector, the agriculture sector, just to name a few. Now, let's start with the healthcare sector. The George Weah administration constructed the 14th military hospital and 8 hospitals in Southeast Liberia, including the New Redemption Hospital in Cowell, the Emory Hospital in Bapolu County, and etc. The George Weah government provided specialist training for more than 19 doctors. They also provided advanced home-based specialist training for over 110 doctors as well. Now, let's talk about the educational sector. The president made public colleges free for every public college student, which in turn benefits about 10,000 college students every single year. The George Weah government made YX free as well for over 40,000 high school students across the country. The administration starts the building of 28 high schools around the country and 18 early childhood schools as well. The government increased the pay of 3,500 teachers from $8,000 to $128. The George Weah government added 1,300 teachers and guidance counselors to the government of Liberia payroll. The government also digitized the University of Liberia and its registration process, which in turn makes it easier for teachers to access courses online and students to go through the registration process. Now, let's talk about the infrastructure sector. The George Weah government built several new government offices, including the Freeport of Monrovia head office, the LFA or Liberia Football Association headquarters, LPRC or Liberia Petroleum Refinery Company's headquarters, the new Maritime Authority's headquarters, and the refurbishment and construction of NAFAA or the National Fishery and Agriculture Authority's corporate headquarters. The George Weah government also paved the Ganta to Harper Road to better help residents access from Harper to Monrovia.
Off the road too much. If I go, I get the motorbike, just take down with me and just carry me straight.
In the youth development, gender and social protection sector, the George Weah administration renovated the major sport park in the country, including the Clariton Film, the Dual Community Sports Park, the Invisible 11 Sports Park, and the BHP Community Project, and etc., just to name a few. The government also renovated the SKD Stadium with turf and modern day seats. The George Weah government created the Youth Employment Strategy, which allows youth as infield salesmen of Orange Lone Star services directly to subscribers. The George Weah government invested in technical vocational educational training in 6 counties, while plan has been laid out to expand to all 15 counties as well. The government of Liberia invested $1 million to transform the lives of disadvantaged youths in Monrovia and various counties. The government invested in sexual gender-based violence roadmap. The administration established a task force to effectively punish offenders and established a call center to easily report rape and gender-based violence as crimes. The George Weah government banned female genital mutilation nationwide, while educating villagers and traditional leaders to report such behaviors as a crime. Now, let's talk about the monetary policy and fiscal policy sector. The George Weah government reformed the Liberian currency with the printing of 48 billion Liberian dollars, including coins, and brought down inflation rate from a high of 30% to 7%, which is one of the lowest in the world, according to Statista.com. The government reformed the salary of 15,000 government employees through the harmonization and downward adjustment of July 2019. The government has reduced wages of the top 1% in Liberia to 12.7% from 13%, with the median pay reduced from 3,200 to 3,500. The government increased doctors' monthly salary from 700 to $2,000. Now, let's talk about the energy sector. The George Weah government connected 130,000 households since 2018, or 7,800 people to the LEC grid since 2018, according to allafrica.com. The government reduced the cost of electricity from 35 cents United States dollars per kilowatt hour to 21 cents United States dollars per kilowatt hours. Let's talk about poverty and growth. The Liberian economy achieved a growth rate of 5% in 2021, which reduced extreme poverty by 8% over the last year, according to World Poverty Lab. In the public safety and national security sector, the George Weah government enabled and signed a dual citizenship law, which in turn protect naturally born Liberians as well. The government increased the budget of the army to 4 million United States dollars in fiscal year 2022 and ended the cutting of soldier pay by 20% to support the Mali peacekeeping mission. The government renovated the national barracks, which improved soldier living conditions and increased the Liberian National Police budget to 3 million in the fiscal year 2022. The government added additional logistics for the Liberian National Police, like weapons, new uniform, accessory to better combat crimes as well. The government also bought more than 10 fire trucks for the Liberia National Fire Service. The first fire trucks arrived in December of 2022. In social inclusion and traditional governance, the George Weah government constructed 20 new market buildings in all 15 counties, including the $430,000 USD market building in Maryland, the Douala market in Douala, the $158,000 market in Plibo area, Maryland County. Now, with the Propo agenda, the George Weah government constructed Propo homes across the country, including housing unit in Tubman Borough, Bowman County, a Propo housing unit constructed in Barclayville, Granville County, and the First Lady of Liberia, Claire Weah, constructed the City of Hopes, which aims to provide better living conditions for elders and Liberians with no homes. The government provided ambulances, trucks, motorbikes for traditional leaders across all 15 counties in public order, decentralization, and revenue sharing. The George Weah government conducted a government payroll audit system, which drastically improved payroll fraud. The government revised the Anti-Corruption Commission, or LACC, law, which gives more power to the LACC to fight corruption, waste, fraud, and abuse. The government passed the Anti-Whistleblower Witness Protection and the new anti-money laundering laws, and also passed and supported the decentralization and revenue sharing laws for rural Liberia as well. With that being said, that is about it so far. These are the major improvements by President George Weah. I did not get every single one. Also, this whole thing happened within the period of the coronavirus. So if you can see, today, major governments around the world are talking about how the coronavirus, the lockdown infected their performances. Ghanaian president, the analysis, everyone is talking about it. So I feel like the coronavirus also have the effect on the Liberia economy and the government performances as well. Like I said, I was not paid by the Liberian government or my affiliate with anything. That's why I tried my best to do this research over months and avoid Liberian sources as well. And that's about it. I'm going to leave here today. I'm going to be making more videos like this. I'm also coming up with Let me take it to 15 best things about Neba County. And trust me, Neba County is one of the most baddest county in Liberia. When I dropped this video, all my Neba people love it. I didn't even know Neba was this bad. Honestly, I think Neba is one of the most baddest counties in Liberia. But I'm going to leave here today. Definitely check back on the channel for more videos like this. With that being said, I'm out.